Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Bullpen. Oh, he's back. We have Mr. Brad Polumbo, National Review contributor and correspondent, fee.org. Good day, sir. Welcome.
Thanks.
All right. We're going to chop it up about U.S. Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas. There are renewed calls for his resignation from people like Congressman Hank Johnson, who's on the Judiciary Committee, and also calls for impeachment by people like AOC and a few others. I don't want to presume what you know or believe about the actions of Clarence Thomas and his scandal with the billionaire, so I will let you opine and then respond.
Yeah, I think the calls to impeach or to sanction Clarence Thomas are kind of absurd, frankly. I mean, I know the progressives have always had it out for him. They've never liked him. But most of what's been reported ranges from, okay, he should have done that better, to a complete nothing burger. But also, I'm still struggling to see what the actual scandal is, because Clarence Thomas is one of the most predictable justices. He has a very coherent judicial philosophy, whether you agree with it or not, and I don't fully. I'm more of a Gorsuch fan myself, but you can just about predict what way he'll rule on any case because he's very consistent in his rulings, and you can't actually point to any cases where any of this supposed influence that was had on him through different gifts or travel or donations would have made any difference. So I'm curious to hear you explain why exactly Americans should care that he had a rich friend and took some trips with him.
Well, number one, he violated the standard ethical rules of the court. And I'll go ahead and read it to you since you're unaware of what he actually did. So the recent reports of his relationship with the billionaire include a trip worth $500,000 that he took with his wife to Dubai. It also includes property that his mother was able to benefit from after the billionaire bought it because he probably told him to, remodeled it, and then moved Clarence Thomas's mother inside of the property. And as Clarence Thomas said during the first report, he said, hey, I made a mistake, basically.
And no, that's not what he said, because okay, the ethics rules changed. And for until about a month ago, hospitality was exempt from the ethics rules. So the plane staying in somebody's home, considered exempt. Accurate.
No, sir, it's not accurate. I'm going to read it to you. Okay. And then you can fact check me whenever you get a moment. So lodging and food provided on someone's property have been exempted from disclosure. However, transportation itself is not. That is not exempt on the disclosure. Check it out when you get a moment. I know you're not aware of it right now. In addition to the fact he did not do that, he also made his own proclamation about the why. He says, well, these things got more restrictive over time, and I will make sure I explain this or disclose it in the future. So he's saying it was basically a nothing burger, as you described it in the beginning. However, the other justices have gone out of their way to make sure they do update their disclosures to include the things that he said he did not have to include. So let me ask you this question, since you don't think it's a big deal. This guy's a billionaire. We're talking about his friend Crow, right? He's a billionaire. He's not only spending money, he's spending time. He's spending time with Clarence Thomas. Do you believe this multi-billionaire would be besties with Clarence Thomas if Clarence Thomas was not a United States Supreme Court justice?
I don't know. I don't think any of us can know that. I mean,
I'm asking, do you believe, sir?
I think it's very possible, because from what I know of Harlan Crow, he's friends with all sorts of people on the political right, thinkers,
academics. How many people you took to Dubai?
Sorry?
How many friends did he take to Dubai?
I don't know about Dubai, but I know that he regularly has had people from across the right come speak at his estates for events and debates, including actually Democratic politicians have come to speak and been paid at his events. He's somebody with an intellectual curiosity who wants to be around these people. But even so, to go back to your point from a moment ago, Dr. Richey. So you just actually acknowledged that huge swaths of this reporting, like, for example, when he stayed in the villa of Harlan Crow, did not need to be disclosed under the old rules. But even if we say the plane travel, for example, should have been disclosed, okay, then he should amend his disclosure.
That's not what we say, sir. That's what the rules say. The rules provide an exemption status, which you have mentioned on this program. What is not exempt? It says transportation is not hospitality.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Let's
so
go.
I'm correct.
Right. But that means housing is part of that you mentioned. So huge swaths of this reporting didn't actually need to be reported.
Sir, wait a minute. You're telling me that the public should not know that a multi-billionaire.
We're just going by
spending,
the rules that you just read
on.
Off.
Wait a minute, dear brother. Allow me to finish because I allowed you to finish. The public, according to you, should not know about a multi-billionaire who's spending $500,000 on a Supreme Court justice of the United States of America?
I genuinely don't see why it matters.
You don't think that matters at all?
Harlan Crow has never been a party to any case before the Supreme Court. And if he was, I'm sure Clarence Thomas would recuse himself.
Well, let's talk about that. While you say he is not a party to anything before the U.S. Supreme Court, his interests are. Just as you laid out the
Everyone's
case, sir,
interests
wait, hold on,
are.
Hold on, brother. No, you don't get to do that. Just as you laid out how Crow has all of these conservatives that come to his home or come to his events, they provide speeches for him. He has this particular curiosity. Well, he has a political bias. He has a political agenda. That's why he invites individuals who value his political agenda. His political agenda has been before the court many times. And Clarence Thomas made a very problematic vote that confused and confounded Republicans in particular when he said that Donald Trump had the authority to retain executive power even after he was president of the United States. He was the only Supreme Court justice who voted that way, contrary to every conservative and every liberal on the bench. Everybody scratched their heads. Now, all of a sudden, it's starting to actually make sense. And you're telling me that the American public should not be made aware of his actual violations, which are failures to disclose, and his ethical violations, which are his issues with this particular billionaire and his money.
But so they all take, or at least most of them do, take paid trips, including by private jet. And you're right that they've disclosed those. And sure, maybe he should have disclosed some of the things that he didn't. But if whether he discloses it or not, if your point is about the influence, disclosed or not, these paid trips either do or don't influence the justice's thinking. And what I'm telling you is Justice Clarence Thomas for 30 years has had a consistent judicial philosophy.
Well, that's so interesting.
He believes in the unitary executive, which is what was behind that ruling you mentioned.
Come on now. Let's keep it 100. Let's go to Jenny Thomas, his wife. Jenny Thomas was involved in cases that went in front of her husband, Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas. He refused to recuse himself, even though we were aware, or we are now aware, that his wife was directly involved in either A, getting money from these organizations, B, lobbying for these organizations, or C, text messaging her support of the particular movement that he was set to rule on. Why did he not recuse himself? Do you not find any of these elements problematic with a sitting Supreme Court justice?
I think there's a much stronger case he should have recused himself for the Jeannie Thomas one regarding January 6th.
But what about this one? What about the ones I just brought to you? Is it problematic he did not recuse himself of these cases?
About Jeannie Thomas and January 6th?
No, that's not the only one. That's one. But also the cases where she's involved with the organization, the conservative advocacy groups that he has to rule on. You don't think he should have recused himself?
Well, the problem with that is that a lot of judges have a spouse, for example, who works for the ACLU or for who is involved in one of these advocacy groups. And I don't think that's the standard. Whatever it should be consistent.
Well, there is no standard.
Then how can you hold him accountable if there's not a standard?
We're called the court of public opinion here. Just because the Supreme Court has refused or Congress has refused to give them a mandated statutory dynamic, or the court itself is not bound by similar ethical rules as, let's say, a traffic court, just because they have not adopted these rules upon themselves does not mean they shouldn't have them. And it doesn't mean that they should not be judged and weighed accordingly based on public review. So because they have no ethical guidelines due to their own design, you're telling me they can do whatever they choose to.
I think it's harsh to judge people when there isn't a guideline. Maybe there should be. But I guess I would just ask you this. Can you point me to one single ruling from Clarence Thomas that you can actually connect to the fact that he went on trips with Harlan Crow? Because I've looked and I can't. He has the most consistent ideological judicial philosophy of any of the people on the court.
He just broke with his own consistency in recent rulings.
He's been the one vote in dissent from everybody else in too many cases to count. He's on his own island all the way on the right wing of the court.
I study Clarence Thomas's cases because I'm in law school. We have to study a bunch of cases, all right? I see his dissent. I see his agreement. It is ironic that there are some dynamics he agreed to in 1988 that he then does an about face, or 1998, then he does an about face later, 2 years ago. So these things are problematic for the record. And yes, you can point to an evolving judicial philosophy. That's fine. He did not write that in his opinion. He could have, but he chose not to. But sir, you know good and damn well that if this were, let's say, Sotomayor, you would be up in arms. Everybody would be up in arms on the right.
Sotomayor has taken 16 paid trips, including by private jet, according to the New York Times. According to the New York Times. And she disclosed it. Sure.
She disclosed it, sir.
But so if the point is the influence peddling, why does the disclosure matter so much?
Because, sir,
you're either influenced or you're not.
Listen, sir, the reason why it matters is because we pay them to have the highest judicial position in the United States of America. And we expect them to at least adhere to rules that a state Supreme Court judge would have to adhere to, if nothing else, because they are the ones who become the standard for all of the judges in this country. The reciprocation doctrine is strong because typically that bench has been strong. So when you decide to give a Supreme Court justice a pass on something that a traffic court judge would never get a pass on, sir, you've already drunk the Kool-Aid.
I think more judges should look to Clarence Thomas as a role model of intellectual consistency and legal thinking.
Well, why did his intellectual ass not disclose what he did?
Some of it was sloppy paperwork, like the one caught up by the Washington Post. And he
should be better on that.
But he certainly should not be impeached over something like this. That's
crazy. Do you think he should resign?
No. This is nowhere near that level of...
Do you think he should explain himself? Why is his mother benefiting from the billionaire and he didn't disclose that?
They took a loss on that property sale.
No, but sir, you don't think he needs to explain to us what's this all about?
I think his rulings are very self-evident about where he's coming from and why he's ruling the way he is. And none of it has anything to do with trips or his mom's.
You know why you don't know about Crow's influence? It's because
it doesn't exist.
Because the meetings
there.
Were private, sir. The meetings were private. That's
And all the court members take meetings with tons of influential people and activists and donors. And they're all influenced heavily by the people in their lives. Clarence Thomas is no exception.
I got to say this, man. Clarence needs to hire you in case he does get impeached for you to make an advocacy. You damn sure hold the line, dear brother.
The funny thing is I don't even agree with his philosophy fully.
No,
This is a witch hunt.
But you are dead wrong as it relates to the standards that should be here for us. I'm talking about the American people, all right? Not just a rule of law or the bench or Congress. They should be here for us, all right? So that we can have a fair review of their job performance. I do appreciate you being on the show.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.